Hello, my name's Sherry Forsyth and I'm a peak performance coach, and I'm discussing today the topic of authenticity. In the previous two videos, we looked at why it's so difficult to live authentically in today's society, and the second one then on how authenticity and masks are connected. So if you're wanting to know a little bit about those, go and have a look at those videos. But today what we're looking at is how some of our really important values can be linked to authenticity. So we're looking here at the values of courage, all these beautiful sounding values: courage, honesty, transparency, integrity. And actually it all comes under the umbrella of what Brené Brown calls wholehearted living. So the first step to living an authentic life really is knowing and then approving of who you really are, of what you think and what you feel. Because without that, we don't know who we are. So we can't really be showing that kind of authenticity. So only when we know who we are, what we stand for, what our thoughts and feelings are, what we're passionate about, what we will accept and not accept, only then, once we know that, will we then have the courage to be able to show others who we really are. And that is what authentic living is all about. So, a question for you: do you know what you stand for? Do you know what you will accept and not accept? Do you know what you believe in? What influences your thoughts and your decision making? If you don't know the answers to those questions, then you will have some difficulty. So there are two main parts to living with authenticity. The first challenge is to be able to stand up for what you believe in, even if it's not popular opinion. So that's the first challenge. The second challenge is to be able to show people who we are, including the shadow of who we are. In other words, those parts of ourselves that actually aren't so nice. So those are the two components of being able to live authentically. So let's go with the first one, okay? The challenge to be able to stand up for what you believe in. It's so much easier just to go with the flow, to do what society is deeming the right way. So this is where our courage comes in. Because it takes a lot of courage to challenge that status quo, to challenge what everybody else is thinking and believing. It takes courage to swim upstream. And it takes courage to stick with what we know. And in other words, live according to our conscience. Sometimes there are very serious consequences of living according to our conscience. I'm sure many of you are familiar with the story of Sasha Litvinenko, who was a KGB, a lieutenant colonel actually, who had moved to live in the UK and had been living there for quite a long time, was already a British citizen, and he was poisoned by, supposedly, I don't want to be had up for any kind of libel, but apparently it was proven in British courts that the person who was responsible for ordering that this chap was killed was Alexander Putin, who, interesting world that we live in, is now the president of Russia. But he had the courage to say no when he was asked to do things that he deemed to be incorrect. And because he had the courage to say no, he had the courage to show his authentic self what he stood for. Actually, he eventually lost his life. So that is a really serious consequence of being authentic. Hopefully we won't have such serious consequences ourselves. So many people just follow like sheep. And in doing what society always requires them to do, they don't have to think about what they're doing and who they are. And because of that, they actually lose the essence of who they are. They don't know anymore what they feel strongly about, what they have, what they should have, what opinions they have of something. They're just like sheep. They will just regurgitate what society thinks. And the majority view then is accepted. So this is where honesty and integrity will come in as well. In that if, like Litvinenko, you have the courage to be able to say, you know, that is unethical, or I'm not prepared to do that, or I'm not prepared to give people who are underage any booze, or whatever it may be. Or to have the honesty, integrity to own up something that we maybe did that wasn't right. We need to have the courage to own up to that, knowing that there might be consequences. Okay, hopefully not such dire consequences as Litvinenko had. But if we own up to something where we have made a mistake, we need to know that we have to take it on the chin. We have to embrace the consequences of our mistake, which then takes the courage, because it's much easier just to lie and not have to face those consequences. Does that make sense? So we have to have a lot of courage to dig deep and listen to our soul, to know what we really think, what we really believe. And what helps us to do that is if we live a value-based life. Okay, so in other words, we know what our values are, but we live according to them. We don't just pay lip service to them. So if we know what our core values are, then it's much easier to live authentically, because those values guide us and they help us to make the correct decisions, or in other words, the authentic decisions. So if a situation arises that's going to challenge my authenticity, if I know what my values are, it's much, much easier for me to make a decision that will be within authentic living, that will be within my my set of core values. So we need then to have the courage to know what our core values are, and then to make the decisions according to what they are. And that will help us hugely in being able to live an authentic life. So I want you to take a look at your values. Do you know what your core values are? Your top 6 to 10 values? What really guides you? What helps you make decisions? What value is speaking to you when you feel something is not quite right? So I want you to have a look and see if maybe your values, core values, will include things like courage, living with authenticity, integrity, being genuine. And I ask you to clothe yourselves in those values to help you to live an authentic life. Does that make sense? Okay, the second challenge, as I mentioned in the beginning, is to live life authentically, is to show people the essence of who we are, which is the good and the bad. In other words, it will include how wonderful we are, but it will also include the shadow of who we are. In other words, that's the side that we all have that's not that great. And to live authentically, we need to be able to show people the good and the bad. We need to show our shadow selves as well. And that requires confidence and courage, because it's much easier just to put on a mask and pretend we don't have that negative side, and hence the video on masks and authenticity. So let's not put on those masks and pretend that everything is okay and pretend that we are absolutely perfect. We aren't, okay? We need to challenge ourselves, okay, to have a look at our shadow selves and accept them and be able to portray them, knowing that it might offend some people. We might actually lose some relationships, but then is that really, are those relationships worth being in if they aren't authentic? So we need to challenge ourselves to do the same to others. If others can love us with our shadow side, let us do the same and let us love them with their shadow side. To love them for their humanness. To love them because we know, according to that quote, that to err is to be human. Okay, so we are going to be making the mistakes. So let's love them with their imperfections. And so we'll pave the way for allowing them to reveal their authentic self to us without fear of criticism or, judgment. I hope that makes sense. So I challenge you to choose to live an authentic life, okay, which will enhance and improve your connection with others, because they will immediately feel and know that they are dealing with an authentic being on the other side, and they will connect. If they feel that there are masks or there's falseness in what you are doing or saying, there's an inability to connect because they know that it's not the real you that is coming through. So if you are able to live authentically, a very real and strong and connecting bond is formed. So I want you to become one of those people that others would consider to be a person of value and integrity by living 100% authentically. By living 100% authentically. It's not easy. And remember, in trying to live an authentic life, we make that choice every day with little issues. We can show whether we're authentic or not. But the very important point to remember is that you are good enough just as you are. You don't have to pretend anything. So let's go out and look for the authentic people, and let's give them also the chance of being authentic. Let's create that platform for them. So as always, thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate and value your time. If you have any comments to make about this video, as always, I really love them. Please feel free to drop a comment in the comment box below. You can also follow me on Instagram, on YouTube, on LinkedIn, and join me next week for finding out what is the authenticity paradox.